Australia's Prime Minister Anthony Albanese and Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton have both agreed that enough is enough with the detention of Australian journalist and WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange in the UK. Albanese, currently attending King Charles's coronation in the UK, has stated publicly that he is continuing to raise the issue through diplomatic channels and that Assange's mental health is concerning. Dutton backed Albanese's position and publicly agreed that the matter had gone on for too long. He has also been backed by a number of other Australian politicians since the issue of Assange's detention was first raised, and there have been diplomatic efforts made in the past few years to help ensure his freedom and clear the extradition bid requested by the US. For a decade, Australian leaders have been reluctant to publicly call for the Assange's release. However, this week marked a turning point. Both Australia's Prime Minister and Home Affairs Minister spoke openly about their desire for Julian Assange's case to be brought to an end swiftly and diplomatically. Of course, this is not the only matter that Dutton and Albanese have discussed, though it is one of the few issues which the two have spoken about as one. When it comes to other domestic matters such as welfare, Dutton is calling for balance. He's expressed his sympathy for people on fixed incomes, noting his support for allowing pensioners to work extra hours. He also added that while additional support was needed due to the increased cost of living, he was concerned if those payments would lead to inflation and higher interest rates. It appears that the future of Julian Assange is still up in the air. However, we can be grateful that the leaders of Australia's major political parties both publicly back a diplomatic intervention in the case. The action taken by Prime Minister Albanese and Minister Dutton speaks volumes, and we can only hope that their efforts will lead to Assange's freedom and a resolution to this ongoing issue.